Hello, everyone. It's time for Vanish Chicagoland Stories, the podcast. I'm your host, Pete Costanis. This is episode 242, season 10. Today's date is July 30th, 2023, and welcome to the show. I am back for another episode, so here we go. On today's program, I am going to talk about Chuck Cavallini's restaurant that was located in Midlothian, Illinois. Oh, what a wonderful place. And also I'll talk about the 40th anniversary of the debut of the TV show that aired on NBC, Friday Night Videos. Yeah, I had some great memories watching that show. And so that's an interesting lineup, suffice to say. Okay, so I will get started with the program, but first the program will go into a commercial break. And this program is brought to you by Lipton Lemon Tree Lemonade Mix. That's a lot of L's, you know. Reminds me of in the Superman comics. You have Lex Luthor, you have Lois Lane, and you have Lana Lang. All the L's. I hope I didn't leave anybody out. Okay. So here's the commercial. It's from 1979. So sit back and relax, and I'll be right back with the show. Thank you, everyone.
Lemon tree, it's from Lipton, got that fresh squeezed lemon taste.
Come on, try a lemon tree.
Lemon tree, it's from Lipton,
got that fresh squeezed lemon taste.
From the juice of real lemons,
lemon tree's got fresh squeezed taste.
Lemon tree, the lemonade flavored drink mix from Lipton. Fresh squeezed taste with no artificial flavor.
Thanks, Mom.
Lemon tree, it's from Lipton,
got that fresh squeezed lemon taste.
Get fresh squeezed taste with lemon tree.
Okay, everyone, I am back. I hope you enjoyed the commercial for Lipton Lemon Tree Lemonade Mix. The song that's playing, that's like a parody or a takeoff from the song Lemon Tree. It was a folk song written by a songwriter. His name was Will Holt from the 1950s. And but it was originally written in 1930, but I can't read it because it's in Portuguese, so... And that was used, it was sung by a lot of people. So the song, one of the lyrics is very famous. It goes like this. Lemon tree, very pretty, and the lemon flower is sweet, but the fruit of the poor lemon is impossible to eat. It's so catchy. I love it sometimes. And then the most successful singer that sang the song was Trini Lopez. I don't know if you remember him. He was a singer, actor. He was in the movie The Dirty Dozen, if you remember the movie. But he sang that song. And he sang it beautifully. And other recording artists sang the song were Peter, Paul, and Mary, Chad and Jeremy, the Kingston Trio, the Seekers, Bob Marley, Herb Albert, Roger Whittaker. Oh my God, it's hilarious like that. And as for the product, I think it was introduced like 78, 79. There was like stiff competition between lemonades. Like, for example, there was Country Time. There was this product. What else? There was Minute Maid Lemonade Crystals. Do you remember that? Yeah, Weiler's. All kinds of that. Kool-Aid made lemonade. You know, so you had a lot to choose. I love lemonade. It's one of my favorite drinks. I don't drink enough of it, but it's good. Especially for a hot day. It really is. It's refreshing. Okay. So right now, at the beginning of the program, I mentioned I'm going to talk about the Chuck Cavallini's restaurant that was located in Midlothian, Illinois. Also, the 40th anniversary of the TV show Friday. I forgot the name. Friday Night Videos. Excuse me, I had a brain fart. Yeah, it's terrible. You know, it's early. Okay, so before I get started, I want to mention a few things. We had some deaths this week. We had Rocky Wirtz. He was a CEO of the Blackhawks. You know, he was 70 years old. Oh, what a nice man he was. Also, we had actress Inga Swenson. I grew up watching her on Benson. She was Gretchen, the Krause, the cook. She was always at odds with Benson, played by Robert Guillaume. She first appeared on Soap. She played Corinne's mother. Well, she was a funny character. And then she moved over to Benson, where Robert Guillaume got his own show. And she was a hit. She was but I heard off screen she was a very lovely lady. Her most other famous role was she played Hoss's mother on the TV series Bonanza, in flashbacks. I watched that show. So she was acting for a long time. As for Benson, one funny episode I remember about her is she had to get married and it was a proxy wedding. And so Benson stepped in, but they really got married and did the shock of their faces, found out they were. That was a classic. I like that. They were both wonderful. And she died at the age of 90. So that's a shame. It really was. Okay. So that's it. As for my health, I won't go over it because I did that yesterday. But tomorrow I'm going for my blood test. And then we'll see. Then Thursday I'm going to the hospital. I will keep you posted to let you guys know what's going to happen. Okay. So let's get on with the show. Right now I'm going to talk about Chuck Cavallini's restaurant in Midlothian. Someone requested me a while back, why don't you talk about this place? They said, okay. I'm going to talk about it. I'll talk about where it was located, how it was founded, and my memories of this place. Okay. So I found a little history of this. According to the obituary for the founder, this was dated March 15, 1980. The man who founded the place, his name was Peter Cavallini. And he was an ice cream maker. Then he became a restaurateur. He owned the restaurant. And so he came, he was born in Pisa, Italy. Then he came to Chicago. And then he settled in Blue Island. And then he went into the ice cream business in Orsi's Ice Cream Parlor. And that was located on Lamont and Western Avenues. Yeah, so I didn't know that. Then he established Cavallini's. That was a manufacturer of the Arctic ice cream in 1920. I never heard about this. This is interesting. And then it became Metal Gold ice cream. That's interesting too. And then he sold it to Beatrice Foods, if you know that company, 1936. That was not his first restaurant. No, the first one he opened was in Dalton, Illinois. It was called the Villanova. And that was on 599 East Sibley Boulevard, which I didn't know that. And then he later on opened Chuck Cavallini's restaurant. And it was named after his son, Charles. And that was located at 3845 West 147th Street in Midlothian. So how about that? I don't know what year it opened. I'm not sure. Anyway, so the restaurant was famous for their gourmet meals, wonderful menu. What's famous also is their chuck wagon. Their chuck wagon was like a pink-white wagon that served entrees, like, for example, prime rib and maybe seafood and all that. Oh, that was good. Like that. You know what? I found a menu of the place. I really did just now. And they also had a la carte and all that. So one of their famous was their wonderful salad bar, very lavish and all that. Also, they had Italian dishes. Spaghetti, masaccioli, meatballs, like that. Also, they had the Cavallini Special Club sandwich. That was like chicken with crisp bacon, lettuce, tomato. There's lots of cheeses in there. Oh, that's so good. That sounds wonderful. Like that. And other sandwiches too, like roast beef, turkey sandwich, and all that. Also, they had a la carte dinners, you know, like seafood, steaks, chops, chicken, breaded veal cutlet, veal parmesan, you know, wonderful, wonderful, delicious food like that. And let's see what else. Also, they had entertainment, you know, as well. They also had Greek cuisine too, which I didn't know that. You know, so some people said that their chicken Kiev was good over there, their prime rib, also red snapper, one lobster. Oh my God, he had it made. He was excellent, you know. Also like antipasto, like that. Entertainment, you know, he brought people like for example, there was somebody named Jerry Pierce. He appeared, and that was during the 70s, and he entertained like that. Also, he had banquet rooms there, like for weddings, business meetings, receptions, like that, birthday parties, like that. I don't know about Greek parties, you know, like we, like when I went to weddings or baptisms, not really, but to tell you the truth, I only went once there, unfortunately. And that was at my younger brother's graduation ceremony. He held it there. And this is a funny story. And it was a great place. The food was excellent and everyone was invited. My mother was there. My father didn't come because he had to work. The funny story was there were some kids that were sneaking beer, you know, like from the bar, or they brought their own and they were drinking it. And they were like, I saw one kid like took a can of beer and he sneaked in and took a sip. And they got caught. And then some older person bought beer for her brother, and they had him under the table at some empty table. And I don't know if it was my mom or some other lady noticed that. And they, you know, they flip over the tablecloth, and there it was stacked upon, all, you know, stacked like that on top of each other. And then my priest came, they told my priest, he was there, and they showed it to him, and he was very angry. I don't blame him. So they didn't catch who did that. I don't know. I have no idea. But it was so funny. But I remember the food was delicious. The place was great, like that. And then the place lasted for a long time, and then it closed in 1989. Let's see. I think so. Yeah, 1989. I don't know what's there now, so I have no clue. And there's another Cavallini's in Tinley Park, and I don't know if that's related. I have no idea, no clue if it's that. Maybe because I never been there. I never heard of this. Someone mentioned this on Twitter or X. That's what it's called now. And they said, but it was a wonderful place. It really was. And people still talk about it to this day, especially on Chicagoland, you know, or they posted it in my group to approve. They said, do you remember Chuck Cavallini's restaurant? And of course I prove it. And then the comments just roll in. They talk about what was their favorite meals, their favorite events. You know, people said, we had our wedding receptions there. We had our birthday parties there. We had our christenings, you know, for our children, you know, and it was amazing. It really was. And people loved it. They really love that place, and they miss it. I don't blame them. There was nothing like it. I'm sure there were a couple more in the Chicagoland area, but that was very unique. And is that was fine. But let's see. Peter Cavallini passed away on March of 1980. You know, he lives in Florida, so he did that. And he started this establishment. Then his son took over, and I guess they closed. I don't know why they closed. I don't know. Maybe his son didn't want to continue anymore, you know, or, you know, just people went elsewhere. Who knows? I have no idea. Okay. All right. So that's it for Chuck Cavallini's Restaurant in Midlothian. Next up, I will talk about the 40th anniversary of Friday Night Videos. Now, when I posted this yesterday, I got a comment from someone. I think it's a troll, you know, because I suspected it. He goes, why are you going to talk about this? What is the Chicago connection about this show? And like that. Oh, it wasn't Friday Night Videos. Excuse me. It was talk about Fuddruckers. Yeah, I apologize. He goes, why are you talking about Fuddruckers, in Chicago? What's the Chicago connection? You might as well talk about Denny's. I mean, Denny's? First of all, Denny's is still around. I wouldn't talk about that. That's ludicrous. It's like that. But someone else did mention about Friday Night Videos, and he said, what is the Chicago connection? And I said, I rarely do, and I said, look, I grew up watching the show in the 80s. I loved it. You know, they showcase a lot of great videos from the early days. That's why. So it's a Chicago memory and a story of that. Okay. So I'll give you the history of Friday Night Videos and my memories right now. Okay. So here we go. So that premiered July 29th, 1983 on NBC. Originally it was 90 minutes, like an hour and a half. So the anniversary of the 40th anniversary was yesterday, and it was a music video show. And because a lot of music videos were shown on MTV, and a lot of people didn't have cable then, you know, only in the suburbs, but not in Chicago, you know, where I lived at the time. You know, cable came much later, like about 87, 88, that my house got cable, so I missed out on a lot of things. I had to go to a friend's house to watch MTV or other cable shows, and I was very jealous of that. You know, so I don't know. You had the urge to go, and, you know, you feel like you missed out on a lot of things for that. Anyway, so the show was very unique. So they had that great graphic, you know, and that music, like that. And so in the beginning, it was produced by Dick Ebersol. He was a producer of late night programming, like, for example, Midnight Special and Saturday Night Live. So the funny thing is, Midnight Special ran from the mid-70s to 1981. After that, they aired SCTV, you know, the Canadian comedy show that featured John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Rick Moranis, Andrea Martin, Catherine O'Hara. That's a funny show. I love that show. But then it was replaced. And then it went to Cinemax. And then for one more year, then they stopped production like that. And then they wanted to produce Friday Night Videos, you know, for people who didn't have cable, or, you know, or like people didn't go out much on Friday night, because like me, I went to DeVry Institute of Technology. I went to college then, you know, I was too tired to go out with my friends or go out anyway, so I stayed home because I did a lot of studying. Or if I had free time, I did. But then I stayed home and I watched the show, and I did that. So I started watching that show, and I enjoyed it very much. I really did. So it aired Friday night, but then Late Night with David Letterman aired from Mondays to Thursdays. It did that there. And then and then it was moved back in 1987, and it cut down to 60 minutes. So it aired right after David Letterman, kind of late like that. But I stayed up and watched it anyway. Okay. All right, so right now I'm going to play the introduction of Friday Night Videos. When I come back, I will talk about a little bit more about it, about the show, you know, and what they had hosts who hosted the show. There were celebrities, musicians, and how it ended. Okay, so this introduction is from 1984, and you will hear Mick Jagger speaking briefly. Okay, and you have the host too. So sit back and relax, everyone. Thank you.
Tonight on Friday Night Videos, an exclusive private reel with Mick Jagger.
Party, party, party.
Brand new videos from Stray Cats, Billy Idol, and the Gap Band. A video vote between Van Halen and Lionel Richie, with a free t-shirt given away every 15 seconds during the voting. A classic video by the Rolling Stones, plus Michael Jackson, The Police, Duran Duran, John Cougar Mellencamp, Huey Lewis and the News, Reflex, and Cindy Lauper.
Okay, everyone, I'm back. I hope you enjoyed the introduction of Friday Night Videos that featured Mick Jagger. He was going to be interviewed on the show. Also, the announcer made videos from those artists as well. The most popular feature of the program was video vote, which is they play two videos back to back, and viewers like me would call in to vote on which was the most popular. And they would announce it at the end of the show, and then they would face another challenger at another week like that. And when a video won four consecutive video votes, excuse me, declared a retired champion. And then they start with two new videos and they start all over again like that. And they offered, so you use a 900 number. Remember that? You call a 900 number with a fee. And so they offered free t-shirts every 15 seconds during the time period, you know, when viewers would call to register their votes. That's kind of cool. Like that. I wish I'd get a t-shirt. I never did this. You know, anyway, the announcers of the shows in the beginning, they were narrated by two men. One was Nick Michaels, and the other one was Scott Mooney. And he was, Nick Michaels was a voice actor and writer and producer, and the other one, Scott Mooney, was a disc jockey like that. But those guys were there from the first two years of there. And then there was no announcer, I think. Anyway, so let's see what else. Then they also had Hall of Fame videos that showed famous artists, you know, and they were profiled in private reels. And they made, and you know, and they also made new clips debuting their world premiere video. So you also didn't have just in the 80s, you know, from artists, you had like, from the 60s and 70s, they would appear. And that's probably from clips of TV shows, you know, not really videos like that. And they would present it, you know, like the Doors, the Rolling Stones, the Beatles, any artists from there. That was fun to watch. Okay. Let's see what else. Then, beginning on October 1985, they had celebrity guests as weekly hosts. And this would last until March of 1991. So you had some very famous people. Not just musicians, but you had actors, comedians. It's a long list. It's a lot, you know, people from like that. And then, let's see. So they had a lot of TV shows, from The Cosby Show, Cheers, Night Court, the cast from The Facts of Life, the cast from Kate and Ally, you know, New Kids on the Block. That's the artist right there. You name it, they had it. People from Saturday Night Live, you know, Hulk Hogan hosted a show, you know. It's good. Michael J. Fox hosted. It's fun to watch these people that appeared, you know, and they also introduced the videos like that. Some were hilarious. Some were just funny. Yeah. So anyway, then the format changed in 1990. I like that. Then they didn't show videos. They changed all that, and the format changed around early in the 1990s. They moved away from all video programming, and they introduced just other artists, and that was sort of the grunge era, like in 91 too, like Nirvana, Soundgarden, and all that. But also they had rap singers. Not just pop and all that, and indie rock. They showed that. Then they started showing comedians, you know, and they would tell jokes, and then it became unrecognizable, just like MTV. They did that. And then they had live studio musical performances, like, for example, like Unplugged, they did on MTV. Then, let's see, what else? So, you know, one of the hosts that later on was Tom Kenny, and he did the voice of SpongeBob SquarePants. That's one of his earliest jobs. He was there, and they did that. Who knew like that? Then in 1994, they changed the logo and the title to Friday Night. That's it. And they moved this. And in January of 1994, they moved the studio from New York to Burbank. That's when they did that. And they hosted more. Then they had stand-up comedians, celebrity interviews. And then, you know, it wasn't Friday Night Videos anymore. Not really, you know. So, and then in about 2000, they changed it to Late Friday. And then it was, you know, it changed. So I didn't watch the show after that. I only watched it from the 80s, and that's it. You know, I guess I lost interest during the decade of the 80s. That's how it is. And then it was canceled. And what replaced it was Last Call with Carson Daly. That's what replaced the show. You know, it was like that. So that's how it was. But, you know, watching the music videos in the 80s was a real treat for me and a lot of people. You know, oh, it was a great time. You know, I know some of them were silly, some were memorable, and some you never saw because you didn't have MTV, but you actually saw on this show. You know, and you sit down and you're waiting for the next video to come. You had to sit there like that. I mean, you had VCRs back then. Not many had that as well. So that was a great time in the 80s. It really was like that. Now you can watch music videos on YouTube like I do. Sometimes I do. Or on your phone, on your desktop, your tablet. Streaming, you know, any time of the day or night, whenever. Okay. Oh, someone mentioned, like, you know, Channel 7 on WLS had a similar show called Rock on Chicago. I think that debuted a year later, 1984, and that was hosted by Brant Miller, who does the weather on WMAQ TV Channel 5. He was a disc jockey from WLS back in the day, and he hosted. But I think that show lasted about maybe a couple of years. So someday I'll talk about that show. We'll see. Maybe for the 40th anniversary of that, which will be very interesting. Okay. So that's it for this program. I'll do a recap of what I talked about. I talked about Chuck Cavallini's restaurant in Midlothian, Illinois, and also the 40th anniversary of Friday Night Videos that aired on NBC. This program will be published later on. It'll be available wherever podcasts are. Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music. Also, it'll be on my YouTube channel, Vanishing Algonquin Stories. To those apps I mentioned, please subscribe. And also on my YouTube channel, please subscribe. You know, on Vanishing Algonquin Stories, the podcast. Subscribe and you'll be notified for a new episode. Also be on my blog, vanishingalgonquin.blog, and also on my social media page, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Twitter's not called that. It's called X. Okay. And also, yeah, so it's Facebook, X, Instagram, also the new one, Threads. It'll be there. Okay, so that'll be a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. Excuse me. All right. We'll do another episode Tuesday. I'll see if I have time. You know, because it's going to be a busy week for me going to the doctors and all that. But, you know, I'll let everyone know. All right. So this is Pete Costanos, your host of Vanishing Algonquin Stories, the podcast. Thank you for joining me. I enjoyed talking about this episode. That was a lot of fun. So here's bye-bye for me. And here's a little traveling music with Ray Rayner, of course, saying bye-bye-bye. Take care, everyone. So long.
We have to go. Bye, bye, bye.